Hi there, everyone. My name's Chris Rosser, and I'm Flusso's Head of Systems and Applications. And today, I'm going to be taking you through the process of setting up your FLS110 evaluation kit, calibrating it, and then measuring and logging flow and temperature data with the FLS110. So let's get started. So the first thing you're going to want to do when starting your evaluation is familiarize yourselves with the contents of the FLS110 evaluation kit. So this is the USB to I2C adapter. It takes the I2C signal from the FLS110 sensor module and converts it into a USB interface, which you can plug into your laptop. There's this ribbon cable, which is used to connect the sensor module to the USB to I2C adapter. And there's the FLS110 sensor module itself. This will come fitted to the fixture that you requested when you ordered the evaluation kit. I have the through-flow fixture here for between 0 and 500 SCCM. Now, in order to evaluate the sensor, you'll need to pass air through it. Now, you could use a lab air source, or you could use something as cheap and simple as this. This is a fish tank pump that I bought for just a few dollars. It has two outlets, and I've just taken one of the outlets and blocked it off. And I'm going to use this second outlet to pass air through the FLS110. You're also going to need a flow controller and a reference flow meter. Now, something like this AliCat mass flow controller is a good solution for both of these things. It incorporates inside it a reference flow meter, and also it's got a proportional valve, which means it can control the flow very precisely, which is useful for calibration. This is a 500 SCCM mass flow controller, and of course that matches up nicely with the 500 SCCM fixture that I have here. In order to start evaluating the FLS110, we need to connect all these components together. So the first thing we're going to want to do is connect the outlet of our fish tank pump to the inlet of our MFC. Flexible tubing makes this so easy. Once you've done that, you're going to want to connect the outlet of the MFC to the inlet of your flow fixture. Now, your flow fixture will have an arrow on it marking the direction of flow. Mine goes from left to right. And we want to make sure that if there is an arrow on your mass flow controller, that's also going the same direction. And then we simply connect the flow sensor module to the outlet of the MFC, like so. And that's all the fluidic connection that we need at this stage. We need to make the electrical connection. And this is going to be done by using this cable here. We're going to connect one end of the cable to the USB to I2C adapter, and the other end of the cable to the FLS110 sensor module. Now, don't worry about getting the orientation of the connector wrong, because this is a keyed connector, so you can only put it in one way round, and that way round is the correct way round. Once you have this set up, you can plug it into your laptop. I've got this just simple USB extender cable here, so I'll just use that. And we're also going to want power for our mass flow controller. I have a power lead for this mass flow controller here. Okay, you can see that that's powered up. And then finally, we're going to want to power up our fish tank pump. So once we have the fish tank pump running, we can set our MFC to some value, let's say 100 SCCM, and check that we get 100 SCCM passing through our mass flow controller, and therefore also passing through our FLS110. If you've got to this stage, then your fluidic setup is done, and all that remains now is to set up the FLS110 GUI software. So we'll do that now. Now, initially, when you plug in the USB adapter into your laptop, nothing will happen, and that's completely normal. You need to download the FLS110 GUI software in order to make the evaluation kit work with your laptop. And you can find this at flusolimited.com. In the customer portal. So if we go into the customer portal, we'll see that on the left-hand side here is a menu and that there's a software section. Inside the software section, you'll find the latest version of the GUI. At the time of this recording, the latest version is 5.1. So you'll want to download the folder like that. If you go to where you downloaded the zip folder, open the zip folder and extract it, you'll find that you have this application files folder and this setup exe. To install the FLS110 evaluation kit GUI, just run the setup exe. If you do get an error like this, you can just run anyway, and that's fine. Again, and just click run anyway. And if you see this, no serial ports found, check connections, that just means that you may not have plugged your FLS110 USB to I2C adapter in yet. You can just click OK. So once everything is connected and ready to go, you simply search for FLS on your start menu, and you should see this evaluation kit GUI application come up. If you run that, you should see this screen. This is the FLS110 evaluation kit GUI. And the first thing you'll want to do is just check that the sensor is working. So let's go ahead and start the sensor. It's this button here. And we can see that initially the sensor is reporting zero flow and a temperature of 28 degrees. If we now pass a flow through the sensor, I'll set this mass flow controller to 100 SCCM. You can see that the sensor begins to report 100 SCCM. And if I turn the flow down, let's say I turn it down to 50 SCCM, you can see that the sensor drops to 50 SCCM. So if it's all working like this, then you are set up and ready to measure flow. Once you're happy that you've got the sensor measuring flow, the next step is to calibrate the sensor for your particular system. And to do that, we're going to use this offsets and calibration menu down there. We're going to start with flow temperature offset correction. If you click that button, you'll see this dialog box pop up, and you'll want to enter the ambient temperature that the sensor is currently at, which I know in this room to be 27 degrees. And that will complete the temperature offset correction. Then you'll want to make sure you have zero flow through the sensor, and you'll want to do a zero flow offset correction. Obviously, just confirm that you've got no flow through the system and zero differential pressure across the sensor. Click go. And that will complete. And then the final step is to do a three-point system calibration. This will set all of the coefficients in the firmware to the correct values for your system. Now, to do this, there are a few different options that you will need to go through. The first is to choose your measurement basis. Now, if you're looking to measure mass flow, you can select this mass flow measurement basis here. If you're measuring volumetric flow or differential pressure, you'll want to be selecting this one here. I want to measure in SCCM, which is a mass flow unit, standard centimeters cubed per minute. So I select mass flow. Then we'll want to choose the first, second, and third set point. And a good rule of thumb, if you're just starting, is to set 10, 50, and 90% of your measurement range. So 10% for me is going to be 50 SCCM. 50% of my range is going to be 250 SCCM. And 90% of my range is going to be 450 SCCM. Once I have those set, I'm going to set my mass flow controller to 50 SCCM, the first set point. And once that's done and the flow has stabilized at 50 SCCM, I'm going to click go. And then I'm going to set my mass flow controller to the second set point, 250 SCCM. And again, once the flow is stabilized, I'm going to click go. And finally, I'm going to set my mass flow controller to the final set point, 450 SCCM. And once the flow has settled, I'm going to click go. And there you can see that the three-point calibration has successfully completed, and you should be getting accurate and repeatable measurements from your FLS110 evaluation kit. Now that the sensor is calibrated, you may want to log some data for further analysis. So to log, you simply tick this log data button. Make sure that the path that you're saving the data to is where you want the data to be saved. Here it's going to save onto my desktop and the file is going to be called data.csv. And you might want to add a comment. So I'm going to put evaluation kit test. And then when you start measuring, logging will start as well automatically. And so now we are both measuring and logging flow and temperature data from our FLS110 evaluation kit GUI. I hope you found this video tutorial useful. Should you have any questions about using your FLS110 evaluation kit, please don't hesitate to reach out to us. All that remains is for me to wish you a very successful evaluation and a very good day.